Hi, Sabrina here from Havoc Mayhem Creations with another tutorial for you, and this is the newborn baby butterfly photo props outfit. It's actually a beanie that has little antlers and a little flower on the side. That's optional. You could actually not need the flower, but I like to like dazzle my stuff up. And then it has this little thing that you put on top of the back of the baby when they're laying down and crunched up, and it's beautiful butterfly wings to make the baby look like a butterfly. So I had a lot of people asking me, how do you make that? Well, I had an order today to finish, and I'm making this tutorial for you guys so you guys can learn how to make this cute little butterfly photo prop little outfit here. So the colors I'm using is a petal pink and orchard from Red Heart Super Saver. This is worst weight Super Saver yarn. I'm using two hooks. I'm using the 5mm hook for the butterfly wings, and I'm using a 4.25mm hook, which is a G hook, for the beanie. Also, a tempers needle to sew on all those ends, and you will need scissors, of course, to cut those ends off. So let's get started. To get started, we're going to start off by using the petal pink yarn and the 4.25mm hook, a G hook. You're going to start off by making a slip knot. This is the way I make my slip knots. Everybody does theirs differently, so whatever feels comfortable for you, but for those beginners out there, I'm going to show you exactly how I do it my way. I wrap the yarn over my fingers twice. From the back, I'm going to tuck this over. Pull it just a little bit. You don't need to pull it a lot, okay? I'm going to take my fingers out and then grab the two ends, and that little part that I had the loop on, I'm going to pull it. So there is my slip knot. I take my hook now and put my hook into that little loop, and you pull on the loose end, this loose end right here, to adjust the length of your loop. Okay? You don't want it too tight because it's going to be very hard to like slide it back and forth on your hook, and when you're trying to put another loop inside, it's just too tight. So try to have your, not too loose, but a little loose just to play around with, you know, understand? We're going to start off by chaining up four. You yarn over, which you put the yarn over your hook, and then you're going to take this yarn and insert it into this loop. Just like so. That's a chain one. You're going to do that again. Yarn over, insert it into the loop. Two. Yarn over, insert it into the hook. Three. Yarn over, insert it to the loop. Four. So now we're going to do is a double crochet. Double crochet is a little bit more difficult. You're going to yarn over and go into your first chain. The first chain you did is at the very end right here. The very first chain you did. And you're going to go right into that loop. Yarn over again. Pull the yarn through. Yarn over. Pull through two loops. You're going to have two more on your hook. Yarn over and pull through the last two. That's a double crochet. One more time. Yarn over. Insert your hook into that same stitch. Yarn over again. Pull the yarn through. Yarn over. Pull through two loops. Yarn over and pull through two more loops. Just like so. So now you did two double crochets. We're going to continue until we have 11 double crochets made. You are going to count your chain four as a double crochet, so you should have a total of 12 pulses. So let's continue on until you have 12. Once you have 12 on your hook, this is a string you want to pull on it to bring that center in perfectly, and so you don't have to have a big hole in the middle. What you're going to do now is you're going to slip stitch on the first top of your chain 4 to join. Now you're going to chain up 2, double crochet in the same stitch as the chain 2, and in every stitch you're going to put 2 double crochets in every stitch. So what you're going to do is you're going to go into your next stitch, put a double crochet, and once you're done with that, you're going to make another double crochet into that same stitch, making it 2 in the same stitch. And you're going to do that for every stitch all the way around, putting 2 double crochets in every stitch all the way around. I'll meet you there. Okay. Once you're done with your 2 double crochets in every stitch around, you should have a total of 24 double crochets. Now what we're going to do is slip stitch on the top of our first chain 2 to join, and chain up 2, double crochet in the same stitch as the chain 2. The next stitch we're going to put 1 double crochet. The next stitch you're going to put 2 double crochets. The next stitch you're going to put 1 double crochet. The next stitch you're going to put 2 double crochets into the same stitch. And we are going to repeat this pattern all the way around. 1 double crochet in the next, 2 double crochets in the next. So it's going to be like 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, all the way around. And we're going to do that all the way around by putting the same pattern. We already did 2 here, so I'm going to do a 1 double crochet here, 2 double crochets here, 1, 2. And you're going to repeat this all the way around until you get to the end. I'll meet you there. Okay, so once you finish, you should have a total of 36 double crochets, counting your chain 2 as a double crochet, you should have a total of 36. We're now going to slip stitch to join on the top of our chain 2. And now this is the crown for the newborn size beanie. What we're going to do now is no longer doing any increases, we are just going to chain up 2. Double crochet in the same stitch as a chain 2 in every row that we do, and we're just going to double crochet in each stitch, just 1 double crochet in each stitch, and start building the length on this beanie. Just like so. Bit of a knot here. And your project should start curling up. We're getting that roundness that we need for it to shape over the baby's head. You can see it start curving. And that's exactly what you want. Just one double crochet in every stitch all the way around. I'll meet you there. Okay, so I've already finished doing my last stitch, and now I'm going to slip stitch to join. And we're going to repeat the last row. We're going to chain up two, double crochet in the same stitch as the chain two, and double crochet all the way around. We're going to do this until we get to the ninth row. Eighth row. So we already are in 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have another 4 rows to go in double crochet. So we're just going to continue doing the same thing we did on the last row for the other 4 more rows. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, the next 4 rows, we're going to do the same thing, just double crochet all the way around. When you get to the end, slip stitch to join and chain up 2, double crochet in the same stitch as the chain 2 and double crochet all the way around. I'll meet you there at the end. Okay, so I finished my 8th row and we're going to slip stitch on the top of our chain 2 to join. We're going to chain up 1 and we're going to half double crochet into the same stitch as the chain 1. To half double crochet, it's similar to a double crochet, but you're not going into 2 and 2 loops. What you're going to do is yarn over, insert your hook into the same stitch as the chain 1, yarn over again, pull the yarn through the stitch, yarn over, and pull through all 3 stitches, just like so. I'll show you one more time. You're going to yarn over, go into the next stitch, insert your hook, yarn over, pull the yarn through the stitch, then yarn over again and pull through all 3 loops, just like so. We're going to do that all the way around, a half double crochet in each stitch all the way around. Okay, my last one, I'm now going to slip stitch to join, and what we're going to do now is just fasten off from here. Our beanie is complete. Pull the loose end right through the loop and pull tight. Get your needle now and sew in your ends. And you also want to sew in the end that you have on top. So now we have our beanie made. Now we're going to make the two antennas going up. So let's place this aside. Grab your pink yarn, make a slip knot. Your hook again. Insert your hook and chain up three. One, two, three. What you're going to do is slip stitch in your first chain. Then you're going to have like this little tiny circle. It's very tiny, very, very tiny. Okay, and what you're going to do is single crochet into that center of that circle. And we're going to single crochet six times. So inside, one, two, three, four, five, and six. Now, for you beginners out there, if you need to, get a piece of yarn, or what I like to use is bobby pins, and you're going to mark this. You're going to use it and use a stitch marker if you don't know where you're ending up at. And what we're going to do is we're going to single crochet all the way around again. So what you're going to do is pretty much go into your next stitch instead of slip stitching and do a single crochet. One. Then you'll put your marker right in there. And let me show you exactly. I have a piece of string here. Take it, slide it right through that stitch. And now you mark that stitch. So what you're gonna, that's your beginning point. So that's where you know where you're gonna end up at. In that same stitch again, you're gonna put another single crochet, making it two single crochets into the same stitch. Now we're gonna put two single crochets in every stitch all the way around. So here's one, two. Next one, and two. Next one, two, and so on. Now we're at that marker again. We're going to take that marker out and you're going to single crochet into that marker. Now what you want to do is mark your new stitch. So put your hook into the stitch where you just did your single crochet. Take the string again, pull it right through to mark it. And this round, we're just going to single crochet all the way around. One single crochet in every stitch all the way around. it's gonna start forming over, just like you did with your beanie. One more to go. Now we're at the marker again. Take that marker out, single crochet into that stitch, and place your marker into your new stitch. For those that are beginners, so you understand where you're going to end up at. This round, we're just going to do the same thing again. Single crochet all the way around in every stitch. Okay, we're at the marker now. Now what we're going to do is take that marker out and we're going to decrease. So we're going to go into one stitch, then you bring the yarn through, then you're going to go into the next stitch over, yarn over, pull the yarn through. You're now going to have three on your hook, yarn over, and pull through all three. Just like so. We're going to do, now take your marker and mark your new stitch. Now we're gonna do that all the way around. We're gonna go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull the yarn through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull the yarn through. You have three on your hook, yarn over, and pull it through all three. Do that all the way around till you get to the marker. So we're at the marker now, and this loose end is bothering me, so I'm going to pull it right through so it won't be in my way no more, and I can sew it in afterwards. There we go. So we're at the marker now. Take your marker out, single crochet into that stitch, and you can put your marker right back in for those that need to know. Okay. Now we're going to single crochet in every stitch all the way around. Going to be a little bit harder now because all the stitches are nice and like you have a little bit to do. So make sure you take your time and just do it. Okay, so I'm at the marker again. Take the marker out. Single crochet into that stitch, and you can place your marker back into that stitch. What we're going to do now is build the length of our little antenna, and the antenna should be from the beginning to the end about 3 to 3.5 inches long, depending on how big you want your antenna to be. So from here, as you can see, I'm going to start building the little length to 3 inches. So you're just going to basically single crochet in every stitch all the way around until you get to that length. that's about 3 inches now, as you can see here. I'm gonna finish my last two stitches here, and what we're gonna do is slip stitch and fasten off. So now I'm gonna slip stitch in my next and fasten off. You're gonna make two of these in the same length. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sew in all my ends. Now, it's optional, but what you can do is you can actually stuff the inside if you want to. Pretty much all I do is I take like my loose end yarns here and put them in there, take a larger hook and push them in there. That's it. That's all I do. And the stuffing will go inside. So it's a little bit more firm. So you're gonna make two of these. Once you have two of them, come back here again. Press pause right now. Okay, so once you're finished with both little antlers, we're gonna sew them on. So what you're gonna do is just take a little bit of yarn here. Really don't need that much, just a little bit. Thread your needle. Get your beanie, and what you're going to do is on the second row you're going to sew these on to the very corner right here, see, right there, and you just pretty much just go around. I like to grab the top stitches. Okay, once you're done, just tie a knot. Really good knot. Cut your end. And do the second one. Same thing. Line it up with the second row. Make sure your beanie is folded nice in half, just like so. And work the other side. and go around one more time. I just feel like I didn't do all the stitching. I'm just gonna feed those ends right into this thing. Dress it off. There's our little baby beanie. Isn't that adorable? Oh my god, I'm just loving this. So then I have a flower tutorial, and what I do is I do the same flower that's in that tutorial, and I'll put the link below so you can do that. And I just added a little pink button in the center of the flower, and that made this even more cuter than ever. So let's go on the second part of this outfit and do the wings for this butterfly. Okay, for the wings, we are going to make a slip knot. And we are going to chain up 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. There's our 12. What we're going to do is yarn over and into the fourth chain we are going to do a double crochet. And we're using the 5mm hook now, not the 4. And you're double crocheting all the way down the chain. Chain up 2, turn your work around, put 2 double crochets in the same stitch as the chain 2. 1, back in the same stitch again, and 2. We are going to double crochet all the way across. The last stitch will put 2 double crochets. Here we are at the last stitch. Last stitch to put 2 double crochets. Chain up two. Turn your work around. Double crochet in the same stitch as the chain two. And double crochet all the way across. Chain up two, turn your work around. Double crochet in the same stitch as the chain two, and double crochet all the way across. Last stitch, chain up two, turn your work around, put two double crochets in the same stitch as the chain two, double crochet all the way across, the last stitch, put two double crochets. Last stitch, put two double crochets. One, back in the same stitch again, and two. Chain two, turn, double crochet in the same stitch as the chain two, and double crochet all the way across. Last stitch, chain two, double crochet in the same stitch as the chain two, and double crochet all the way across. Last stitch, chain two, turn your work around, two double crochets into the same chain two space, double double crochet all the way across. The last stitch, put two double crochets. Last stitch, one double crochet, back into the same stitch again, and two double crochets. Chain two. Double crochet in the same stitch as the chain two, and double crochet all the way across. Last stitch, chain two, turn your work around, double crochet in the same stitch as the chain two, and double crochet all the way across. Chain two, turn your work around. Now we're going to decrease. We are going to put two double crochets into the same stitch. So what you're going to do is go in the same stitch as the chain two. Pull through. Let me show you again. Yarn over, go into the same stitch as the chain two. Yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, pull through two. Then yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull that yarn through, yarn over, pull through two loops, then yarn over and pull through all three. That's a double crochet decrease. Now we're going to double crochet all the way across until the last two remaining stitches, and we'll do another decrease. Okay, I'm at my last two stitches. I'm going to yarn over, go into the stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, then yarn over, and then pull through all three. Chain up two. Turn your work around. We're going to do another decrease. We're going to go right into the same chain two space, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, then yarn over, and then pull to draw all three. Double crochet all the way across until you have two remaining stitches. I'm at my last two stitches. I'm going to yarn over, go into my stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, and pull through all three. Chain up two. We're going to do a decrease. So go into the same stitch as the chain two, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, then yarn over and pull through all three. Double crochet to the end of the last two remaining stitches. I'm at my last two stitches. I'm going to yarn over, go into my stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, and pull through all three. Now the bottom part is complete. What we're gonna do now is chain up one all the way around the whole thing. Make it a nice clean border. So let's just single crochet all the way around. When you get to a corner here, I like to put two double crochets in every little corner that I have. Now I'm going to single crochet in between the rows and in the rows. I'm at a corner here, so I'm going to put two, and now I'm going to single crochet on the top. Because it's a chain, I'm going in between my posts of the double crochet. At a corner, I'm going to add two, and start single crocheting all the way along the end. You get a loose end, just lay it right on top and you're crocheting it in. And at the end here, add one more to the corner here. Slip stitch on the top of your first single crochet and fasten off. Pull the yarn through your loop, pull nice and tight. Take your needle and sew in your end. Now this is the base. This is what they're gonna lay right on top, right where the neck is at. This is the neck part, and then it goes around the body and towards the butt. We're going to attach our wings to this base here. So to get started on the wings, let's get the other color yarn, the purple, or whatever color you're gonna use. I'm using purple for mine, which is an orchard, and let's get started on those wings. Okay, so you're going to grab your purple yarn, make a slip knot. Do that again. Okay, so we've made our base, and now we need to make the wings to attach our base on. This is the large size one, and this is the small size. And we're going to make two of these sets each. I've already gone ahead and made one of each, and now I'm going to make the other set. So you're going to make two of each size of these. You're going to make a large size, two of them, and you're going to make a small size, two of them. So let's get started on that. I'm using the 5mm hook, G hook, and the color, your second color of choice, which I'm using Orchard. You're going to start off by making a slip knot. And we are going to chain up 6. We are going to double crochet into the 4th chain from the hook. And we're going to double crochet in the last 2 remaining stitches. Chains, actually, not stitches. So 3 more, just like so. And you should have this. Now what we're going to do is chain up 2. You're going to put 2 double crochets in the same stitch as the chain 2. Double crochet in the next stitch and put 2 double crochets into the next stitch. Chain 2 and we're going to turn our work around. Insert 2 double crochets into the chain 2 space. Double crochet into the next 3 stitches, 1, 2, and 3, and then that last stitch we're going to put 2 double crochets. Chain 2, turn your work around. 2 double crochets into the same stitch as the chain 2. Now we're going to double crochet all the way down until the last stitch, and we're going to put 2 double crochets into that last stitch. So 1 double crochet in every stitch until the last stitch. The last stitch, you put 2
double crochets.
Chain two. Turn your work around. Two double crochets into the chain two space. And we're going to double crochet all of the way along into the last stitch and insert two double crochets into that last stitch. Last stitch, put two double crochets. Chain two, turn your work around. Put two double crochets in the same stitch as the chain two. Double crochet in every stitch to the very last stitch and put two double crochets into the last stitch. Last stitch, put two double crochets. Okay, so chain up two. Turn your work around. Now we're going to start decreasing. So we're going to yarn over, go into the same stitch as the chain two. Yarn over, pull the yarn through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull the yarn through, yarn over, and pull through two. Do that one more time because my stitches came loose. Okay, and then you're going to yarn over and pull through all three, just like so. Now we are going to double crochet into the last two remaining stitches and we're going to do another decrease. In my last stitch. Now I have two remaining stitches, one and two. I'm going to do another decrease, so yarn over, go into this next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, then yarn over, go into the next stitch, which is the last stitch, then yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, and pull through all three. Chain two. We're going to decrease at the first stitch, so we're going right into the same stitch as a double crochet, or chain two, sorry, not the double crochet, and we are going to do a double crochet decrease, just like we did before on the last row, just like so, and now we're going to double crochet in every stitch all the way down our row into the last two remaining stitches, and we'll do another decrease. And we're going to continue this on into the last rows. So I'm at my last two stitches. I'm going to do another decrease. Chain two, turn my work around, decrease in the first two stitches. So you're going to do like that. Double crochet all the way across into the last two remaining stitches and do another decrease. I'm at my last two stitches and I'm going to do another decrease. Okay, so now we're going to do another decrease in the first two stitches. Double crochet all the way across into the last two remaining stitches. My last two stitches, I'm going to do another decrease. Chain up two. Turn my work around. Decrease in the first two stitches. Double crochet in the next, decrease, double crochet decrease on the next two stitches, chain up two, turn your work around, and then just double crochet in the last three stitches, one, two, and three. Just the last remaining stitches that we have, we are not doing any more decreases. We're just going to double crochet on those three stitches. And we fasten off from here. And you will be making two of these. These are the large wings. And there's one. And there's two. Now we're going to make the smaller wings. Smaller wings are similar to the top wings. Make a slip knot. We're going to do again, chain up six, one, two, three, four, five, and six. Double crochet in the fourth chain from the hook. One, two, three, and four. Double crochet in the next two stitches. Chain up two, turn your work around. We're going to do an increase, so we're going to put two double crochets into the first stitch where the chain two is at. One double crochet in the next. And the next stitch, we're going to put two double crochets. Chain two, turn your work around. Again, we're going to put two double crochets in the first stitch with the chain two. Double crochet in the next three stitches. One, two, and three. The next stitch, you're going to put two double crochets. Chain two. Turn your work around, two double crochets into the chain two stitch, double crochet all the way across, last stitch, put two double crochets. Okay, chain up two. Turn your work around. Two double crochets in the same stitch as the chain two. Double crochet across into the last remaining stitch. The last stitch, two double crochets. Chain two. Turn your work around. Now we're going to start decreasing. And we're going to decrease on the first two stitches just like we did before. We're going to double crochet across into the last two stitches and we're going to do another decrease. Missed a stitch. Hold on. Okay, so chain two, turn your work around, decrease in the first two stitches, double crochet all the way across, last two stitches, decrease, chain two, turn your work around, decrease in the first two stitches, double crochet to the last two remaining stitches, decrease in the last two stitches. Chain two, turn your work around, decrease, double crochet in the next, decrease in the next two stitches, chain up two, and double crochet in every stitch across. Fasten off. And that's the smaller wing. And you'll make two of those. Once you have two of those done, we're gonna get that pink yarn again, or whatever color you're using. Make a slip knot. I'm going to go into the corner right here, attach my yarn, chain up one, and I'm going to single crochet all the way around the whole wing. On every single wing I'm going to be doing this. So I'm going to lay my loose end down and start single crocheting in each of the rows in between them. and single crochet all the way around. When you get to the end, slip stitch to your first single crochet and fasten off. Okay, sew in the loose ends, and you're going to do that for all four wings. Reach there. Okay, so once you've already single crocheted all the way around each one of your wings, we're going to sew them on. Before we sew them on, we're going to make a little tiny piece that goes in the center. So what you're going to need is your pink yarn and your 5mm hook. Make a slip knot. Chain up 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. We are going to double crochet in the fourth chain from the hook. Then we're going to double crochet along the whole chain, putting one double crochet in each of the chains. Getting tangled here. The last chain, we're going to put 3 double crochets into that last chain. 1, 2, and 3. Now we are working on the opposite side of the chain, and we're just going to double crochet back down again. Okay, when you get to your last one, you want to put two double crochets into that last one. Slip stitch on the top of your chain four to join. And then you'll fasten off. Now what we're going to do is put our stuff together. The top ones are going to be the large wings. So the large wings are going to go on top of this. The small wings will go on the bottom. And you're going to place them just like the way I'm showing you right here. You're going to get a lot of yarn. Something that will go around the whole perimeter of this, and you're going to sew this on. When I sew mine on, I go into the top stitches. So pretty much I go right into the stitch, grab it, and then I grab the very top stitch of the work and sew it on. And I start from one corner, start sewing around. When I get to the end here, I start attaching this one on and go around as well. When I get to right about here, I start sewing this on and this one on and so on. So I do one at a time pretty much. Once I have one on, I'm gonna start by adding the other one on. Once you have all your items sewed on, all your wings and they're perfectly even the way you want them to be, you'll take your middle piece that you just made right here and you'll place it right in the middle here and sew that on just to cover the inside of this part area, and you'll sew that right in the center. So I'm gonna sew mine off camera because it's gonna take a while, and I'll be back here with the finished product. And now we are done with our butterfly photo prop baby outfit, and it is just too adorable. Once you're finished with yours, let me see how, send me pictures. You can send them to me on Facebook. I have a bunch of links on my channel you can go to, and you can share your pictures, or you can comment and chat if you have any difficulties with anything. Just comment below and let me know what you guys think. I'm always here. If I don't answer right away, I will answer within that week. Until next time, you guys, happy crocheting. Please like and subscribe my channel and have fun with it. Happy crocheting. Bye.